Christmas time is here. Happiness and cheer. Fun for all the children call their favorite time of year.
Welcome to the debut of On Frozen Pod, brought to you by On Frozen Blog. I'm John Keeley, and I'm seated next to Comcast Sportsnet, Lisa Hillary. Lisa, thank you for joining us, and you have notable achievements in your broadcast career. You've covered the NHL playoffs, you've covered the Grey Cup, I think the Winter Olympics. Where, in relation to those events, does this appearance rank?
This appearance meeting here, now that I'm living here, or with you?
Well, on Frozen Pod.
Oh, this is huge. This is just huge, yeah, to be able to be here with you and the skaters here. I actually feel like I'm at home right now.
We are at the Sculpture Gardens Ice Rink down at the National Gallery of Art, right here during December, during the holidays. This is our Christmas episode, the theme being Christmas with Lisa Hillary. We'll learn a little bit about Christmas traditions in Canada, and specifically Ottawa with the Hillary family later on. I also want to take this opportunity to introduce Andrew Tomlinson. He's new to On Frozen Blog. Andrew is a sophomore journalism major at American University, and I read some of his clips. He's been credentialed by the Caps all season long, and his clips were so impressive, and he handles multimedia for American University's newspaper, The Eagle. So we were really impressed with his skills, and he wanted to champion a podcast for OFB, and so he is manning our pod camera today, and we are thrilled that he's doing that for us. And I can promise you, 2009, readers and viewers, Andrew's going to bring you some stuff that you're really, really going to like. Lisa.
Yeah.
You came to Washington in 2007. You were recruited by Comcast. Gosh, it's so cold out here. It's about 30 degrees out here.
Stop wimping.
Well, it's like, I got to think today, in these conditions, there'd be about two people in Washington who'd be comfortable here chatting hockey with me. One would be the Canadian ambassador to the United States, and the other would be you, which is appropriate because I feel like you're an ambassador to Washington for hockey.
Well, thank you. No, I'm really enjoying it. It's been just over a year and a half since I've been here. I'm having a wonderful time. That everyone has embraced me like family, and I'm having a great time.
Tell us a little bit about that process. You were up in Canada. You were let's start with how you got into broadcasting. I'm very curious. And I'm also curious to know where that intersection of your broadcast career intersected with hockey. I mean, did you start out saying, I want to be a broadcaster in hockey? Or
no, actually, football. I wanted to be a sideline reporter from the time I was just a young girl.
We'll edit that out.
I grew up, my father owned the Canadian Football League team, the Ottawa Rough Riders at the time, back at home when I was really young. And my sister and I sort of just grew up watching sports on television. You know, mostly football, and then, you know, hockey, of course, in the wintertime, but we were big skiers, so we were out on the slopes a lot of the time, so we'd go to too many hockey games, per se, but, you know, once I was able to get into the field, I mean, I had to learn all the positions.
This football team-owning father of yours, I have this suspicion that he's much different, and I mean much different than Daniel Snyder.
Well, he's almost twice his age, but...
Yeah, I wasn't referring to his age.
Yeah.
Anyway, earlier this month, I got criticized for my performance in the hot dog eating contest here.
I'm sorry about that.
For the record, I came in third place.
You should be proud of that, John.
Well, how many hot dogs? What's the most number of hot dogs you've eaten in one sitting?
I tell you what, I won't sleep to pass you away. I'm not I don't really like hot dogs, but I will tell you that I ate two Big Macs.
In one sitting?
Yeah.
Yeah, you never
back
show.
Back to back.
You don't show.
Thanks.
Thank you, Lisa. Now, tell me about life in Canada. Well, foremost among my interests, how many times have you seen Russian concerts?
You know what? I think I saw twice, maybe? Well, once for sure, if not twice.
I
yes.
love you. I mean, that's great.
I know you like Rush. You just saw the race over, didn't you?
They
were here in the summer?
As a matter of fact, Rush came to Hershey Stadium. And I took Tim Leone of the Patriot News to the show, not knowing that you liked to go to Rush concerts. What was I thinking? Well, yeah. Tim's better looking, that's what I was thinking.
Oh.
So No. Now, did you air drum during Neil's solos? During
no, the concert? No. I'm really big into the air drum. I don't even think I actually paid to go to the concert. Free tickets. So, sorry. Yeah. Probably could have hooked you up too, John, had I known. What was I thinking?
All right. Well, let's get back to your broadcast career, because this is interesting. Lisa, when I was thinking about who would be the first guest on Frozen Pod, I wanted somebody comfortable in a broadcast setting.
And everyone else said no?
Well, I wanted somebody also that had fluency with the Capitals and hockey. And frankly, I wanted somebody that had a little bit of pizzazz, could pull in some ratings. So naturally, I thought of Steve Colby.
Oh.
But Steve came up sick today, so we appreciate you being such a trooper with the Royal Canadian Mountie. Everyone, we really appreciate you stepping in.
Second choice.
No, first choice.